हेलो फ्रेंड्स, अकॉर्डिंग टू योर डिमांड आई एम डिलीवरिंग द पोर्शन ऑफ फोर्थ यूनिट कंप्लीट थियोरटिकल आर्टिकल. नोट्स आर गिवन टू यू, बट यू प्लीज केयरफुली ऑब्जर्व एंड लिसन टू माई वीडियो. अंटिल एंड अनलेस यू ऑब्जर्व एंड लिसन इट केयरफुली, यू कैनॉट अंडरस्टैंड द नोट्स. सो आई एम डिलीवरिंग द टॉपिक्स and then you refer the notes. First you observe the video and then you refer the notes. It will be easy for you to understand the notes. So fourth unit, field effect transistor. Known as FET. FET. Field effect transistor. Previously we have studied one more transistor, bipolar junction transistor, unit 3rd, BJT. There are two types of transistor, BJT and FET. BJT we have studied already. Now it is FET, field effect transistor. The transistor which works on the effect of field. The transistor which works on the effect of field. Field means applied voltage, electric potential. The transistor which operates with effect of field means applied voltages. So field effect transistor, I am classifying the transistor. GFA, GFR junction. Junction field effect transistor and MOSFET. M for metal, O for oxide and S for semiconductor. Metal oxide semiconductor MOSFET. Junction field effect transistor, metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor. Junction field effect transistor is categorized as N channel, P channel. In BJT we have studied NPN and PNP transistor. NPN and PNP transistor. In FET it is little bit different. N channel, P channel. I will explain it later on. N channel, P channel junction. In MOSFET there are two types. Depletion type MOSFET, known as D-type. And enhancement type MOSFET. Known as E-type. So there are two types of MOSFETs. Depletion type MOSFET, enhancement type of MOSFET, D-type, E-type. D-type is operated in two different modes. Depletion mode, D-mode, depletion mode, and enhancement mode. Depletion type, enhancement type. In depletion type there are two modes of operation, depletion mode, enhancement mode. And again N channel, P channel. N channel, P channel. N channel, P channel. So this is classification of FET. FET there are two types. Junction field effect transistor JFET, metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor MOSFET. Junction field effect transistor N channel, P channel. Metal oxide semiconductor, there are two types, depletion type, enhancement type. Depletion type is operated in two different modes, depletion mode, enhancement mode. And then again N channel, P channel. So this is about fourth unit. For each FET we have to study its construction, working and VI characteristics. So I will explain construction in 2-3 lines, working in one paragraph, and then I will draw the characteristics. This much only you have to write for 6 marks. Explain JFET. Explain depletion type MOSFET. Explain enhancement type MOSFET. Or explain working and draw the characteristics. Any question, whatever is asked, you have to explain Everything which I am giving you. What I am giving you? I will give construction of each equity. Two-three lines. Working. A paragraph consisting of 5 to 6 lines. And then VI characteristics. Right? So, junction field effect transistor, we will study N-channel. In MOSFET, we will study depletion type, in which we will study two modes, depletion mode, enhancement mode, N-channel, and enhancement type, N-channel. All N-channel devices I am going to explain. Now, what is the difference between P-channel and N-channel? I have previously explained you, NPN and PNP transistor. What is the difference? Carriers change, current directions change, voltage polarities change. Same way here. N-channel and P-channel. When the device is switched from N to P, all the current direction and voltage polarities in the circuit are reversed. No more difference. So we will explain this, and this. Four working, four major characteristics. 1, 2, 3, 4. If you are asked to explain depletion type MOSFET, you have to explain depletion type MOSFET in both modes, depletion mode, enhancement mode. So this is one article having two sub-articles. Actually, we have to study three FETs with working and wear characteristics. JFET N-channel, depletion type and enhancement type. But while studying depletion type, we have to study two modes of operation, depletion mode, enhancement mode using N-channel. So I am going to explain these construction, working and wear characteristics. Now this is N-channel JFET. First you have to explain construction, then working and then characteristics. This is about construction. Now what is construction? A block is drawn where N is written. So this portion is known as channel. N-channel means it consists of electrons. This portion is known as channel. And it can be seen that in that channel, two P regions are deposited. These two P regions are internally connected with each other. These two P regions are internally connected with each other. And there are three terminals. In BJT, we have three terminals, base, collector, emitter. Similarly here, in place of base, here it is gate, G for gate. In place of collector, here it is drain, D-R-A-I-N, and source. Gate, drain and source. These are the three terminals of FET. This is N-channel FET symbol, gate, drain, source. Arrow inside is N-channel, arrow outside is P-channel. Right? This vertical line indicates channel. So in construction, what we have to write? I am not giving you the theory notes here. Theory notes are already given to you. You can go through the notes. I am explaining it. It is written in the notes. This is construction in theory. It consists of N type of silicon semiconducting bar known as channel. This is N type of silicon semiconductor. So what you have to write? It consists of N type of silicon semiconducting bar known as channel. This is channel. N channel. It consists of N type of silicon semiconducting bar with two P regions deposited in the bar. It is seen here. It consists of N type of silicon semiconducting bar with two P regions deposited in the bar. First line. Second line, these two P regions are internally connected with each other and the common terminal taken out is gate. Other two terminals taken out are drain and source. These last two, three lines about construction. This dotted region, it is known as depletion region. We know as soon as PN junction is formed, depletion region is formed. This I have taught you in PN junction, second unit, second or third unit. PN junction, as soon as PN junction is formed, depletion region is formed. So this and this portion is known as depletion region. Initial depletion region in the FET, right? Now working. In working, we have to connect one supply here and one supply here.
and then we have to explain working. So I am connecting. Between gate and source, voltage is applied minus to P region. JFET is always reverse operated device. JFET is a reverse operated device. So minus to P region. And one supply between drain and source. One supply between gate and source known as VGS. Other supply between drain and source known as VGS. Right. So first case, VGS equal to 0. This is 0. Second case, VGS slightly increased. And third case, VGS is sufficiently high equal to VT. I will explain what is it. Three cases we have to study in one thing. First case, VGS 0. I am explaining working. You have to explain working in three paragraphs, two lines. First, VGS 0, vary this and explain what will be the current. Then increase VGS slightly, again vary this, explain current. Again VGS increased. So this is initially when VGS is 0, when VGS is 0. Now I am going to vary this and I am going to study the current. When VGS is 0, the channel is full of electrons. Now I am increasing this voltage, VDS, minus here and plus here. The channel is N-type. The channel is N-type means it consists of electrons. Electrons, negative charge carriers. So this negative will repel the electrons, while this positive will attract the electrons. The channel is N-type, it is full of electrons. This negative terminal will repel the electrons, while this positive terminal will attract the electrons. So electrons will flow from source to drain. Electrons will flow from source to drain. And direction of current will be from drain to source, opposite to flow of electrons. Current flows, current direction is assigned opposite to flow of electrons. Our electrons are flowing from source to drain. So channel is full of electrons, you go on increasing the voltage, electrons will be energized, slowly the electrons are energized, they will flow from source to drain. Slowly the electrons are energized, they are flowing from source to drain, drain current goes on increasing. And a stage is reached when all the electrons are fully energized. Channel consists of number of electrons, electron starts energizing, current goes on increasing. Slowly all the electrons are energized. A stage where all the electrons are energized, the current will remain constant. You go on increasing VDS, electrons goes on energizing, current goes on increasing, and a stage is reached where all the electrons are energized, current is constant. I am increasing VDS, current is increasing, and this is the point where all the electrons in channel, there are number of electrons. So we are increasing the voltage slowly, the electrons are energizing slowly, the current is increasing slowly, and a stage is reached where all the electrons are energized, then current will remain constant. So that current is indicated as IDSS. Drain to source, direction of current. Drain to, electrons are moving from source to drain, so direction is opposite to that. Drain to source. Drain to source, saturation current. Saturation, maximum current. When all the electrons are energized, current will be maximum. So that is IDSS. Drain to source, saturation current. You can go through the notes, it is defined IDSS. I for current, direction from drain to source, and S for saturation. So this is when VGS is equal to 0. When VGS is 0, first. So first paragraph, what you have to write? When VGS is 0, VDS is increased, electrons are forced to move from source to drain, drain current goes on increasing, and a stage is reached when complete channel is completely energized, so current reaches its maximum and remains constant. That is first. Second, when VGS is slightly increased. Now I am increasing the voltage here. Some negative voltage is applied on P region. We have studied in PN junction, when PN junction is reverse bias, width of depletion region is increased. This we have studied. In PN junction, we have studied PN junction with zero bias, PN junction with forward bias, PN junction with reverse bias. So in reverse bias, we have studied when PN junction is reverse bias, width of depletion region increases. So negative will reverse bias this P region. So PN junction is reverse bias. So width of depletion region is increased. So width of depletion region is increased. From both the sides. So width of depletion region is increased means depletion region is the region where there is no current carriers. I have explained you the region in which there are no current carriers. So size is increased means size of channel is decreased. In previous case, the channel was this much. Number of electrons. Now channel of size of channel is decreased. It means that conducting electrons are decreased. So size of channel. So what we have to write? When VGS is slightly increased, width of depletion region in the channel is increased. Width of channel is decreased. Now again you start increasing this voltage. Current will go on increasing and finally will remain constant. But now since width of channel is decreased, current will remain constant at lower level. So VGS is increased, width is decreased, current is increasing and it will remain constant. But in previous case, channel was this much. So more number of electrons were there. Now width of channel is reduced. That means number of electrons is reduced. Number of electrons is reduced. That means current will reduce. So suppose that is VGS is equal to minus 2. So first case, when VGS is 0, current goes on increasing and reaches constant. Second case, when gate is made negative, PN junction is reverse bias, width of depletion region in the channel is increased. Since width of depletion region is increased, that means channel width is decreased. Since channel width is decreased, that means current will decrease. And third case, when VGS is sufficiently high, the depletion region from both the sides block the channel. Depletion region from both the sides block the channel. So even if you increase this voltage, no electron can move from source to drain. Now in this case, electron cannot move from source to drain, and drain current is. We cannot indicate directly zero. Drain current is reduced to considerable. So which is the voltage at which the channel is blocked. This gate source voltage at which the channel is blocked is known as pinch off voltage. What is pinch off voltage? There are two important terms, IDSS and VT. IDSS is maximum current when VGS is 0. VP is maximum voltage when ID is 0. Maximum current, voltage is 0. Zero current, voltage is maximum. The voltage at which the channel is blocked, no electron can move from source to drain and current reduces to 0. So, voltage 0, current maximum, voltage maximum, current 0. Voltage dependent device. Flow of current depends on voltage. Flow of current depends on voltage. So, this is first characteristics known as drain characteristics. And second is transfer characteristics between VGS and characteristics is between VGS and ID. What we have stated, when VGS is 0, current is maximum. When VGS is 0, current is maximum. And that is the VGS. And when VGS is equal to VP, channel is blocked and current reduces to 0. So suppose this is VP. Current is 0. Where voltage is maximum, current is 0. There is current is maximum, voltage is 0. This is transfer characteristics. So two characteristics, drain characteristics and transfer characteristics. So explain working with VI characteristics of JFET or explain JFET. Any question on JFET is asked, you have to write this much. First paragraph, construction. It consists of n type of bar with two regions deposited in the bar. These two regions are internally connected with each other. Common terminal taken out is gate, other two terminals are drain and source. Construction. Working. First paragraph. As soon as PN junction is formed, depletion region is formed. So for working, I have connected one supply here, one supply here. JFET is a reverse operated device, so P region is connected with negative supply. When VGS is 0, channel is from this portion to this portion. Increase this voltage, here minus, here plus. This minus will repel the electrons, this plus will attract the electrons. Electrons go on increasing, flowing, energizing and flow from source to drain. Drain current goes on increasing and a stage is reached where it, which is constant. That constant is known as. Now when VGS is slightly increased, width of depletion region is increased. Width is increased, so channel width is decreased. Channel width is decreased, current is decreased. And third case, when VGS is sufficiently high, depletion region from both sides block the channel. No electron can move from source to drain and drain current reduces to zero. So first characteristic between VDS and ID, this one. And second, when VGS and ID, when VGS is 0, current is maximum. VGS 0, current is maximum. And when VGS is maximum, current is zero. So first characteristics is known as drain characteristics. Second characteristics is known as transfer. Okay. Now after this, we have to study MOSFETs. But before MOSFET, we have to study difference between BJT and FET. In exam, you may be asked the question, right, difference between JFET and BJT, right, difference between MOSFET and BJT, anything. In notes, the difference is given to you. Difference between BJT and FET. You go through those notes and I am explaining the difference between BJT and FET. I have given the difference in the notes. Any difference, JFET, BJT, MOSFET, BJT, any difference is asked, you write these difference, BJT and FET. So first difference is BJT and FET. BJT is bipolar junction device. It is unipolar. Now what is meant by bipolar? In BJT there are two types of transistors, NPN, PNP. NPN. Electrons more, holes less. PNP, holes more, electrons less. But both carriers, current is carried by electrons as well as holes, so bipolar. BJT is bipolar device because current is carried by electrons as well as holes. Unipolar, N-channel FET. I have explained the working. N-channel means current is due to electrons only. P-channel, current is due to holes only, so unipolar. Bipolar, current is due to electrons as well as holes. Unipolar, current is either due to electrons or due to holes. Second, voltage control device. Current control device. Input voltage controls the output current. We have studied in working. VGS is controlling ID. VGS 0, ID maximum. VGS maximum, ID 0. So input voltage controls the output current. Input current controls the output current. We have studied IC is equal to beta IB for common emitter. IB is input current, IC is output current. IC is equal to beta IB means IC will change as IB will change. Output current changes with respect to input current. So current control. Here voltage VGS is 0, current is maximum, VGS maximum current. Voltage control, current control. Third difference, input resistance is high. So this you have to remind well, no need to go in details. Here input resistance 5 kilo ohms. It is very high in mega ohms. Input resistance is very high in mega ohms. Fourth, while preparing IC, integrated circuit, while preparing IC, FET, BJT is less advantages for preparing IC. FET is more advantages for preparing IC. While preparing IC, BJT is less advantages, FET is more advantages. BJT, there is lot of noise. Lot of noise means unwanted signal. Less noise while using FET. In BJT, with temperature, current goes on increasing. So temperature increases, current increases. So there are chances of thermal breakdown. Thermal breakdown means the device may damage due to rising temperature. Current increases with temperature. So there are chances of thermal breakdown. Thermal breakdown means damage of device due to rising temperature. Thermal breakdown means damage of device due to rising temperature. With increase in temperature, its current increases. So a stage can reach where due to excessive heating, the device may be damaged. So that is thermal breakdown. Here, no thermal breakdown. Because current decreases with increasing temperature. Here current increases with increasing temperature, hence there are chances of thermal breakdown. Here current decreases with increasing temperature, so there is no thermal breakdown. So you have to write 6 points whenever you are asked to explain difference between BJT and FET. So working of JFET, construction, working and wear characteristics we have studied. Difference between BJT and FET I have explained. You go through the notes now, you will understand it. And even if you are having some doubts or you are not getting any line, you can talk to me or you can put your query on my WhatsApp number. I will get it solved. Next lecture we will study about MOSFETs. There are two type MOSFET are working. This much is the portion of 4K. Okay, thank you.